Tyson Fury, when he come back, he had two warm-ups and he went in with Wilder. Wilder gave him the chance. Whether Wilder thought Fury was there for the taking, that's a different thing. But I think that Fury will want the third Wilder fight to emphasise his superiority. I know there's talk about Fury and AJ, but at the same time, what you've got to look at is this, whether the contract was signed for Fury and Wilder to have a, you know, this fight. Because I don't think Fury would renege on the deal. And I don't think that Wilder would take step-aside money, because he mightn't get another payday again. You've got to look at it things like that. Because now they say that AJ and Fury, they've been talking. Yeah, but there's nothing been signed yet. They can talk, and now things have come out about involvement of different people and different things like that. But it might be in Fury's interest to fight Wilder. But where does Dillian White stand in this? Because he's been the number one contender for quite some time. Now, and Eddie Hearn, he promotes AJ, and he's also promoting Dillian White. If he agrees to say Fury to fight AJ, say he bypasses Wilder and says AJ, where does it leave him over being Dillian White promoted as well? You know, it's a very intriguing situation, this. But I think personally that Fury will take that fight with Wilder.
Well, it does look like that's definitely going to happen. And one thing promoter Eddie Hearn said recently, that if well, he was mentioning it from his side of things, that if the Fury, and if Fury beats Wilder, he could take on Dillian White before he actually fights Anthony Joshua. Because of,
well, I think he'd have to, because Hearn would be in a hell of a position, wouldn't he?
Yeah, but then would Dillian step aside money at that point? I'm sure he'd just want his opportunity and would take it if a Fury fight was put on the table. So,
I don't think Dillian White would take step aside money either.
No.
He'd want to take his chances.
So that could be the way it goes. Looking back at the third fight with Wilder, you see the trilogies, the great trilogies in heavyweight boxing, and Ali Frazier and Holyfield Bow, just two meetings there that happened that were great fights. It seems to happen, and it's happening again here. It's one apiece, Tommy. You know, is it a case of anything could happen in the third fight, or are you nailed on with your prediction of how it's gonna go? I know you think Fury's gonna win, but you know, how much of a chance do you give Wilder, knowing the punch he's got, etc.
Well, the thing is, I only looking back, I mean, when we were at Oldham Legends Centre, it was the same night. Later on that night, Tyson Fury was gonna fight Wilder, and I said then that one somebody said, well, what do you think of the weight he's put on? And I honestly think this, that Tyson Fury, when Wilder dropped him in the first fight, there was a hell of a punch, hell of a dig. He went down. Somehow he got up and he went back at Wilder. Now, I believe that Fury knew then that Wilder could never knock him out. And when somebody said to me, when I was interviewed, about Fury putting that extra weight on for the return, though I expected Fury to win on points, I thought he wouldn't be doing that unless there was a reason. And I do believe that Fury has got his number. But as I said before, people might say, well, you said that Wilder could not knock Fury out after with that punch he got. But really, I don't know how Fury got up that night. But I don't think anybody knows. But what I'm saying with a puncher like Wilder, you can never tell, but I do expect Fury to win.
Fury is the age-old tactic of putting a puncher on the back foot and thus taking away his
power. Yeah, so you never give him the leverage.
Yeah.
You see, Wilder...
Who would do that again, Tommy?
I'll put it this way to you. In my opinion, Tyson Fury is a natural fighter. And it's in the genes and everything, but Wilder could not get set up for a punch. He likes to use the leverage and everything. Fury went right at him and kept on top of him. And I'll tell you one thing, those tactics paid off. Whether Wilder will have a different strategy this time, I don't know. But with such a puncher as Wilder, has he been in that mindset too long? Whereas Fury seemed, I mean, like people said, when did Fury knock out anybody? And all that. Yeah, he's done it with Wilder. A different thing. You see, this is a difference between a natural fighter. I think whatever Wilder has got, the Fury will counteract.
He's very adaptable.
Yeah, I think, yeah.
I won't be surprised, Tommy, if he came out box southpaw and danced around the ring southpaw, you know, but just done it completely.
Yeah, but you wouldn't surprise me what he does. Nothing, with Tyson Fury, nothing surprises me, because I honestly believe that he's the sort of man that could beat Wilder, AJ, whoever they bring to him, and just walk away from the game and say, I've done it all.
Yeah.
That's the sort of man he's come across to me like that, you know.
It made me think then of something you said before when speaking about Sugar Ray Robinson, the greatest of all time, you know, and boxers like that who could fight with the fighters, slug with the sluggers, but fight with the sluggers and box with the boxers.
Yeah.
You know, and that's when you know a fighter can do that.
But you see, with Fury, when I said that I couldn't pick who was the best between him and Lennox Lewis, but Lewis had more of a track record at that time. Some people derided me, saying Fury was in the same class. Now, some of the same people are saying that Fury is in the same class. The thing is, with Fury and the natural fighter, is they look in range when they're out of range, they look out of range when they're in range, and you don't know. It's natural with them. They can turn a fight around without really knowing, they know they're doing it, but they can turn around down by instinct. I mean, you look at that beautiful left hook that Robinson put on Gene Fulmer. I mean, that was a perfect punch.
Yeah.
I mean, come out of nowhere. He could knock a fella out when he was going back, which is against all of it. You know, things like that.
Yeah, but there's been a bit of a glitch with all that's been going on in boxing. You know, and the heavyweight division was spicing up really nicely before all this. So, let's hope all that can get back on track. And
you see, this is it. I can't wait to see what's happening. And, I mean, you've got it now with Joyce and DeVoice. That's going to be a cracker. to start it all off again.